My name's Mary Pasala.
I'm a grade 6 senior unit teacher.
The students in my grade are very well behaved, eager to learn. Their abilities vary quite considerably. I have students working well below the expected level and well above the expected level. I believe that by having open-ended questions, a lot of open-ended work, that caters to the differing abilities, because if rather than just having closed activities and you have to work out different worksheets for different students, if there's a rich question or a rich problem-solving activity, then the students enter it at their level and take it as far as they can take it. In the lesson today, you'll expect to see students working at tables at their own pace using a simple formula to turn numbers into palindromic numbers. So they'll all be completing, they might be doing different numbers and at their own pace, and some will be challenged with harder numbers.
Okay, you can write them backwards.
Good, good, good.
Does anybody know what they're called?
Molly?
Palindrome.
Palindromes. Who's heard of a palindrome before? What else can be palindromes? Sage?
Numbers.
That somebody produced a little rule for making every number a palindrome. And that's what you're going to be exploring today.
I'll always look at the resource and think, okay, if I'm, and think of a particular student in mind, and what would that student need to complete the activity, or how would that student perceive that activity? And on the other extreme, how would my student who is working well above expected level, how will that student be challenged and be engaged?
Oh, you're seeing the reversals here. Ah. So you'll go 38-83. Ah, okay. I haven't seen that before. That's good.
29 and 92.
So if 29 is worth testing, then 92 would be worth testing.
8 plus 2? 8 plus 2. What is that you need? Okay.
11, 22, 33, 44. It goes diagonally like that. And then on the opposite side, it goes diagonally like that, and we are
done. Have a conversation with your partner and explain, before you explain to the whole class and to me, explain why you've shaded in some numbers and why you have left some numbers blank.
I'm sure.
I think the lesson went fantastic today. All the students were engaged, and students of differing abilities still entered the task enthusiastically and were working at their levels. I thought the lesson through in that I did want a whole class focus to explain the process first, and for them to all understand the process, experiment with working out and actually having that time to work out which numbers are worth testing, and then come back to the carpet and come to a consensus. And then they went off and solved their numbers. And I like the way that we finished off with the Math 300 program and the possibilities of putting in any number you can imagine, and looking at the steps done for them on the computer program. So next session, they will have a laptop and they will just experiment and explore with different numbers. And I think they'll really respond to that and enjoy it.
How do you currently cater for a diverse range of abilities in your class? What kinds of questioning techniques can teachers use to support effective teaching and learning?